Hello and welcome to Linux This Month. Boy, do we have some updates for you this month with the announcement of the first release candidate for the Linux 5.18 kernel, critical bug fixes, and awesome releases. And also, our beloved Fedora turns 36. So now, let's jump into our top story. Linus Torvalds just announced the general availability of the first release candidate milestone for Linux kernel 5.18. This new kernel release is slated to be released in May of 2022, and it has some pretty awesome updates. There are so many to talk about, including updates to support newer processors and GPUs, architecture support for RISC-V, which is the open source equivalent of ARM, sensory drivers, XFAT support for paths with trailing dots, and bug fixes for the ext4 file systems. KVM for Linux on 64-bit architecture has added improvements for Microsoft Hyper-V, Intel IPI, and AMD AVIC support. This new update allows AMD to support up to 511 virtual CPUs in Linux systems. The NVIDIA Tegra video decode driver is also now included in kernel 5.18. The most interesting update included in this new release is the addition of support for the Tesla FOC FSD, or full-scale driving chip. Since Tesla and Samsung both have an interest in the Linux kernel, adding the code to the upstream kernel may lower the maintenance burden with out-of-kernel tree code. So if you would like to download and test the first release candidate for Linux kernel 5.18, RC1 is now ready for download and testing at kernel.org. Two new critical security vulnerabilities were discovered in Linux networking that allow privilege escalation, and they affect multiple Linux releases. The National Institute of Standards and Technologies give both of these vulnerabilities a High Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS score, of 7.8, which on a scale to 10 is a critical bug which gets immediate attention. CVE-2022-27666, a widespread Linux heap buffer overflow vulnerability, was found in the IPsec ESP transformation code in net IPv4 ESP4.c and net IPv6 ESP6.c. In this case, the receiving buffer of an ESP6 module user message is an 8-page buffer, but the sender can send a message larger than 8 pages, which creates the buffer overflow, since there isn't enough space for the data. It flows over, and this causes local privilege escalation, allowing a user with normal user access to overwrite kernel heap objects. This is a widespread vulnerability, since it exists in the IPsec, which almost everyone running Linux uses. This means that the latest Red Hat, Fedora, Debian, and Ubuntu systems can all be hacked. But the good news is that this bug is now patched in Ubuntu, Debian, and the Linux kernel. The second critical vulnerability has been found in the Linux kernel net filter, which provides access to and from the Linux network stack. CVE-2022-25636 is an issue with the handling of the hardware offload feature, where an attacker can cause a denial of service attack to gain privileged escalation, and it even works if the hardware being attacked doesn't have offload functionality. It affects Red Hat Enterprise Linux RHEL 8+, Debian Bullseye, Ubuntu Linux, and SUSE Linux Enterprise 15.3. And the bad news is that the patch isn't available for all versions yet. The good news is that if you don't have a patch yet, there is a workaround. You can mitigate the problem in the RHEL family with the commands echo 0, redirect into proc sys user max underscore user underscore namespaces, then do a sudo sysctl dash dash system. And in the Debian Ubuntu family, with the command sudo sysctl kernel.unprivileged underscore user rns underscore clone equals 0. So with two critical networking vulnerabilities that allow privileged escalation, this could be a lot of work for some of your environments. So go ahead and get started, and happy patching. Ready to start your cloud journey? We've just launched a new limited time offer for our Personal Plus annual plan, giving you a savings of 33%. The Personal Plus plan gives you access to great course features like hands-on labs and practice exams, making it easier to kickstart your cloud career. If you're interested, scan the QR code on the screen or click the link in the description. Debian Bullseye 11.3 has been released with 83 security updates and 92 bug fixes. This latest update comes only 3 months after the release of Debian Bullseye 11.2. This release comes with Linux Kernel 5.110 LTS, as well as a lot of new packages. It also includes some major software upgrades and support for the XFAT file system. Debian Bullseye 11 was released back in August of 2021 and included multiple desktop environments. 11.3 now also adds GNOME 3.38, KDE Plasma 5.20, LXDE 11, LXQT 0.16, Mate 1.24, and XFCE 4.16. This release also contains over 11,000 new packages for a total of almost 60,000 packages. According to release notes, over 72% of packages were updated since the last release. I love that this release contains so many updates. There are so many options for packages, multiple desktop environments, and architecture support that you can see how Debian is staying true to their goal of being the universal operating system. To keep your existing Debian Bullseye installations up to date, just run the sudo apt update and sudo apt dist-upgrade command in a terminal emulator. Fedora turns 36 this year, and they're planning a party, so mark your calendars. This event is slated for May 12th through the 14th, and as per the Fedora community blog, details are still in the works. They did say that they hope to include informational sessions that will feature updates about Fedora IoT, Podman 4.0, and a bunch more current community activities. You can register on Hopin to join the party on May 13th and 14th. Make sure to save the dates, share the registration, and show up to party with Fedora friends. You can register at the link provided in the description. Fedora is calling for testers. The most anticipated distro release of the year just announced the beta release of Fedora 36, and it's available now. It ships with Linux kernel 5.17 and includes GNOME 42 desktop environment with system-wide dark mode, Golang 1.18, Java 17, and GNU toolchain update to GCC 12 and glibc 2.35. The RPM database has been relocated from /var to /user, and adds the default Wayland session with NVIDIA proprietary driver. Fedora Linux 34 will reach its end of life on May 17th, 2022. So go grab version 36 beta and happy testing. That's it for this month's Linux This Month. If you like the show, be sure to give this episode a big thumbs up. Have a question? Add it into the comments. May your source remain open and your code compile. See you next time, subscribe to stay up to date, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.